Good afternoon. Today I'd just like to give a fast overview on academic struggles in cochlear implantation. Of course, the vast majority of children to severe to profound hearing loss who are born to parents with normal hearing want their children to grow up with spoken language. Before the availability of cochlear implantation, this was unattainable. When the first generation of implants became available, dramatic improvements were immediately realized in these children's abilities to acquire spoken language and hence literacy. Almost about half of the deaf children who received cochlear implants began demonstrating performance on a variety of language and literacy within the typical range and sometimes even better. What is cochlear implantation supposed to do? Number one, it's supposed to improve hearing detection thresholds and thus the use of spoken language as a primary mode of communication with improved speech intelligibility. This will improve reading skills and give us a potential for the mainstream education within normal hearing children. What can influence such a factor? Of course, number one, the age of onset of the deafness. Number two, the duration of the deafness. The age of the implantation itself. The status of the cochlear. How the child uses the cochlear implantations and other device factors. These are all common factors. However, certain factors that must be looked upon, such as cognition and attention, this is seldomly looked upon. The previous speech and auditory experience, the nature and intensity of oral rehabilitation, and the motivation may affect a student progress. Additionally, and perhaps the most importantly, continued, consistent parental support is the key to individual student achievement. A motivated family is the most important factor with cochlear implanted children. It is also important to notice that each child has unique skills and educational goals. Students with cochlear implants are individuals with different auditory skills, different cognitive skills, and different methods of communication. Thus, the students' backgrounds, educational experiences, and family support should be considered in determining the services needed to help the students to access and progress in the general curriculum. To optimize such benefits of a cochlear implant, parents must work closely with professionals to ensure the device is constantly working properly and worn by the student daily. Educational resources must be made available and staff must be trained in an address to address the student's specific education needs as per their individual educational plan. There are several factors that affect the children's performance within the classroom for cochlear implantation, probably the most important of which is the acoustical environment. This is the most important factor. How can I affect this? I must be considered that a one-size-fits-all approach, a generalized approach, will not meet the needs of all students with cochlear implants. We can use sign language and spoken language to support each other. However, educational settings that have sign language must ensure the opportunity to develop the use of hearing and spoken language, and services to facilitate the development and expansion of spoken language skills must be incorporated into the student's total educational program. Staff from the cochlear implant center and the educational setting must work collaboratively to meet the student's individual education needs. Many strategies and techniques used to develop language skills with students who have cochlear implants are actually beneficial to all students, since literacy or learning is a language-based process. However, expectations and outcomes must be on capitalizing the student's increased auditory potential. Language development, social-emotional adjustment, and academic success may vary from student to student, and students will need different types of support depending upon the educational settings. In cochlear implant children, hearing achievement development is strongly related to language and auditory skills. Children with cochlear implantation will have problems with phonemic awareness, okay? Will have problem with poor phonological processing skills, will have problem with syntactic skills, will have problems with spelling and comprehension. These are the five main problems for the cochlear implantation. Therefore, development of phonic and structural analysis of phonemes is fundamental for leading development in the early academic years. Phonological awareness and phoneme-grapheme correspondence are considered as prerequisites for reading, and these are a main point of weakness with cochlear implant children. Thus, children with cochlear implant need explicit training on phonemes and phonological processing for better deferring of grapheme-phoneme relationship. Such ability is needed and clear within kindergarten till grade 2. So from kindergarten to grade 2, this is the stage of building the reading abilities. We mainly focus on phonological awareness, phoneme-grapheme correspondence, and prerequisites of reading. After that, in middle primary school, children usually have difficulty with transferring phonemic knowledge as well as phonological processing into more complex multisyllabic words. So when we go into longer words or multisyllabic words, the problem appears. After that, the main difficulty is within the comprehension. Reading is a process by which you understand. It's just not about transcribing six symbols in front of you. The main function of reading is understanding or comprehension. So if you read an entire passage and you do not understand or comprehend what is through this passage, then you are not actually reading, you're just transferring symbols. And thus comprehension is further implicated in reading skills for children with CI throughout schooling. As we noted before, the level of language developed before طول الانجليش اول ذاته هات مستوى اللغه الموجوده عند الطفل ها مستوى اللغه اللي موجوده عند الطفل مؤثر مباشر على القراءه لان القراءه واللغه هما الاثنين نفس الحاجه ولكن حاجه سمعيه وحاجه بصريه فعشان كده بنقول language is essential for efficacy and reading development. The more the language exposure pre-hearing loss, the better the chances. نيجي نفكر في القوقعة هو اتزلع بعد ولا قبل ما كان عنده لغة؟ هو كان عنده فترة كان بيسمع قبلها وبعد كده السمع راح ولا من الأول السمع مش موجود؟ كل ما كان الطفل معرض إلى فترة أطول من تطور اللغة وإلى الخبرات السمعية كل ده ما كان فرصة أكتر إنه يتطور أحسن بعد زراعة القوقعة. ومن المهم جدا الوقت ما بين فقدان السمع والزراعة. كل ما الوقت ده يقل كل ما يبقى أحسن بالنسبة لي. طيب نساعد الولاد دي ازاي؟ عندهم مشاكل وعندنا بروبلمز وعندهم مشاكل في الوعي اللفظي وعندنا مشاكل في الفونولوجي بتاعتهم، نساعدهم ازاي؟ نمبر 1 الاكوستكس السمعيات بتاعت الفصل اللي احنا قاعدين فيه. هما بيتكلموا بره دلوقتي ان لو الفصل فيه ستاتيك الكتريستي ممكن ياثر على وظيفه الجهاز نفسها. فدلوقتي بنقول ان احنا وي هاف تو ماكسمايز ذا ستودنتس ليستنج ابيلتي، يعني لازم نستغل قد ما نقدر السمع بتاعه. ولاد القوقعة يقعدوا قدام ما يقعدوش ورا عشان نقلل الايفكت اوف ديستنس. ما تبقاش في فصل فيه دوشه، الباك جراوند نويز يبقى قليل، مش قاعد لي في فصل وفاتح الشبابيك وانت عندك على المحور بتاع التجمع فالعربيات رايحه جايه ومتوقع انه يسمع زي غيره. خلاص؟ بيتكلموا برضه في صدى الصوت جوه الفصل، بره الفصول بتبقى فيه فصول لو عندنا حتى في بعض الاماكن لضعاف السمع بتبقى معموله بادنج معينه في الحيطان عشان تقلل الصدى الصوت اللي بيرجع. كل دي من الحاجات المهمه. الحاجات التانية اللي بيتكلموا عليها حاجة اسمها assistive listening device او ALD، وده مسمى بس جديد ليه حاجة زي الـ FM system. الـ FM اللي الولد بيلبسه مع القوقعة عشان يزوليت كل الصوت ما عدا الصوت اللي داخل في المايك عنده هو. وفي دلوقتي كلام انه عايزين يعملوها انفراريد ما تبقاش FM خالص. فدي كلها أداة مساعدة للسمعيات. طيب طفل القوقعة اللي داخل في المين ستريم او اللي داخل في مدرسة عادية من المهم جدا انه يتعرض لحاجتين، يتعرض الى تدريبات او مساعدة لتطوير مهاراته اللغوية والسمعية بداء من الاوديتري سكيلز الستة لينك ساوندز بتاعتنا الفونولوجيكال اويرنس بتاعه واللغة بالاضافة الى الحاجات الدراسية او الاكاديمية. فهو لازم يتعرض للجزئين. فالبروجرام بتاع طفل الكوكلير امبلانت في اي مدرسة لازم يكون فيه سبيشاليزد نيدز او جلسات للحاجات اللي هو محتاجها بالاضافه الى الجزء الدراسي بتاعه. طيب بنقول ان في several techniques and strategies that can be used to utilize in school when teaching children. زي ايه؟ في حاجه اسمها auditory sandwich او الساندوتش السمعي، بمعنى عايز اوصل للطفل حاجه، اول حاجه اقولها لفظيا عشان تبقى ايه سمعي، وبعد كده ممكن استخدم حاجه حسيه او حاجه بصريه مساعده، وفي الاخر اقفلها بحاجه سمعيه، فكده اديته الاثنين، بس في الاول سمعي وفي الاخر سمعي، ليه؟ لان انا عايز اشغل السمع قد ما نقدر. طيب في حاجات زي الاكوستيك هايلايتنج اللي هو انا ممكن العب في نبره صوتي او ارفع صوتي او اطلع بالتون او اوطى بالتون، ولكن لو انا بتكلم مع طفل وعلى طول بتكلم مونوتون مفيش اي تغيير مش هجذب انتباهه ليا. في بعض الاوقات وانت بتكلم الطفل مجرد تقول اسمه بيخليه يبص لك فبتجين الاتنشن. في ممكن في بعض الاوقات تقول الاجابه والسؤال الفصل كله بيكررها معاك، فالطفل بيسمع الاجابه وبيسمع السؤال فبيعمل لينك ما بين الاثنين. وفي طبعا ان احنا نعمل تشانكينج، يعني مثلا حتى لما في تدريبات الذاكره لو عايز افتكر حاجه بجمعها مع بعض، يعني مثلا تليفون مثلا بدل ما اقول 2 7 5 1 3 5 4 ممكن اقول 2 7 5 3 5 4. اوكي اخر كلمه خالص بس رول اوف نيوتريشن او دورنا كاخصائيين تخاطب او دكاتره تخاطب. And the number one, assist in solving reading problems by fostering language acquisition and emergent literacy. لازم نشتغل على اللغة بتاعت الطفل وقدرات سمعية بتاعت الطفل. لازم نبتدي نتعرف عامة على الأطفال اللي عندهم مشاكل في القراءة بدل التدخل المبكر بيجيب نتائج أحسن. وإن إحنا مش بس نساعد الطفل لكن نساعد المدرس في المدرسة والأهل في البيت إن هم يساعدونا ويساعدوا الولاد عشان نتقدم فيهم إن شاء الله. Thank you very much.